First things first, recipe, sucker fear. For real, you the only father that I ever knew. I get my bitch pregnant, I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made way back in the
field. Welcome back to the Brood of You.
Mm-hmm.
I'm John.
I'm Ruben.
And we don't have guests this week.
Yep.
We're just gonna
Just gonna riff. What episode is this?
59,
huh?
Yeah, almost 60. Wow. Jesus Christ.
Wow.
I want to start by saying rest in peace to Biz Markie, legendary producer, songwriter, innovator. I'm not gonna act like I know that much about him. I just know all the artists I listen to talk very highly of him, you know, and they always say of how important and legendary he is. So I do want to start with a rest in peace to Biz Markie.
Rest in peace.
I think he was 57 years young, you know, it's a young age to die. But he's been battling health problems for like a decade. I don't know if it's like cancer or something like that, but shit's scary.
It's scary to think about, you know, the big C.
The big C, baby.
But let's move on to lighter topics.
Yeah, I was going to say, we can get off that. I do want to dive into the thing that you sent me.
What did I send you?
Dueling people in person. I feel like dueling should be allowed, and I think you're on the same boat with me.
So imagine a world where you're drinking at a bar and some guy disrespects you. Like, he just, you know, disrespects you, bro. He knocks over your chair while you're sitting in it, doesn't apologize, spills a little beer on you, says, oh, well, it's your fault, right? And like, I challenge you to a duel. And if he accepts, and he's inebriated, and he will, so he'll go, I accept, what are the terms of the duel? So because you challenge him, he sets the terms, and you must agree, and then you both must duel. And the outcome of the duel, there cannot be any legal ramifications, right?
Yes, like, right.
You just duke it out.
I feel like that's the most important piece.
The duel is
no authorities, you fight, and at the end of the fight, it's over.
Well, I'm even going to go a little more liberal with it.
Okay.
It doesn't even have to be a fight. It could be any challenge.
Ah,
right.
I like that. Like,
I challenge you to a duel. All right, throw your hands up, motherfucker. I'm not. I just worked out. I'm not gonna throw hands with you right now. I'm sore as shit. Like, I can't even lift my arm above my shoulder. I'm in pain, bro. Like, I can't fight you.
Yeah.
He's like, then what do you want to do? He's like, we're gonna play corn. You know,
cornhole.
Whoever, with it. Whoever wins, you gotta buy me my next drink.
Yeah.
Right.
Nice.
And that's just
nice.
An example.
Okay, so like, you could be like, if it wasn't even a fight. Say you didn't just work out, be like, nah, first person to 50 push-ups wins.
Right.
The other person who can't do it buys the next drink.
Exactly.
We're done with this.
Like there's a dispute at the airport about whose spot in line it is, right? Like, who's ahead in line.
Yeah.
And you're like, okay, I challenge you to a duel. I'm like, what's the duel? We have to run to the end of the terminal and back. And whoever makes it back first gets the spot, you know? Like,
imagine seeing people do that. You're like, they're dueling.
They're dueling right now. Like, and everyone would be like, oh, clear the space. They're dueling.
Right.
And like, areas would have preset duels. Like, if you walk into a restaurant, like, no fighting allowed here, but there's like a table for arm wrestling.
Okay.
So like, this table's for arm wrestling only. If you have to duel, it must be an arm wrestler in this building.
Right.
If you want to do something else, you have to leave the building.
Right. Okay.
Like, this would be a whole legal thing.
I fuck with that heavy. The whole world should follow that.
That would be this. It'd be a much doper place.
Yeah. There'd be so much less crime.
So much less crime. There'd be so many less people in jail. There'd be less, you know, anger. I don't know. I feel like it'd get
out
of our system.
This was a great topic when you sent it to me. I was like, fuck, this could be actually like a legitimate thing.
Yeah.
I don't know. So the thing stopping that would be everyone's emotions, right? Like, currently, what would be stopping that?
What do you mean?
Like, if you go up to a guy with a big enough ego and say you want a duel, odds are he's going to punch you in the fucking face, and then the cops are going
to
get called.
So, I mean, there would have to be very strict guidelines, right? Like, if you break the terms of a duel, if you don't honor the terms of a duel, then there's something that, you know, like, I don't know. I don't know. You pay more in taxes that year. You don't get as much as of a tax break.
There's a government fucking,
right.
You could just do like a, you know, everyone just hates like if someone's openly racist, people just stay away from that person.
Right.
Everyone just kind of knows. Everyone loses respect for that person. So if like you just like don't duel, everyone's just like, oh, that guy just, he doesn't duel.
Exactly. That's another part of it is that you can reject. So like, let's say you're talking shit at a bar. This guy, again, same scenario, disrespecting you, right? And you're like, fuck it. let's duel right now. We're going to go outside and it's going to be a throwing contest. You got to throw this ball as far as possible.
Okay.
Whoever throws it farther wins, right? Just like something stupid, right?
Yeah.
He goes, nah, I'm not going to duel with you. I'm better than that. Like, he, like, everyone has to publicly shame him. Whoever rejects the duel gets publicly shamed.
Yeah.
Shame. You know what I mean?
Pointing, like, and saying shame might be, that might piss someone,
like,
off.
Like, the next time he orders a drink from the bartender, she's going to pour him the wrong beer.
Yeah, right.
And then she's not going to, like, it's going to be flat.
Yeah. You know, she'd be like, oh, sorry, you want to duel me over it, pussy?
Like, she fills up the cup halfway, shakes it up, and gives it to him, like, here's your beer. And he's like, what the fuck? She goes, next time, accept the duel, bitch.
Right. She's filling it up, and it's just foaming, and she's just staring at him as it's pouring over the side, like, oh, sorry, pour some of that out.
She takes a whisk and goes,
A whisk.
Yeah, and all the carbonation. Right. It's all gone, dude. Right. It's just like the most fucked up beer.
Just smacks it on the table in front of
him. Drink that.
Yeah, drink it, pussy. I fuck with it.
That'd be dope.
Dueling.
That'd be a dope world. What would be your go-to duel? Because, like, go-to, as a person, so, like, the terms are whoever, if I challenge you to a duel, you set the terms.
Okay.
And I agree. If I agree, then we duel, right?
Chess game.
Yours, what your go-to would be, a battle of wits.
Yes, chess game.
100%. So this is another thing about it. It would 100%. Open up people's strengths. Like, are you a philosopher? Are you intelligent? Are you physically capable?
Right.
Well, if you're fast, you're going to challenge people to a racing duel 9 times out of 10.
Yeah.
Because you're fast.
Right.
And you know you can win. Dude, this is the dopest concept.
This is a fucking dope concept, dude. This is great. This is amazing.
This is great.
So what would yours be? I'm dueling you. You get to set the terms.
I haven't given it thought. I'd have to think about it.
I bumped into you a little aggressively, and then when you turned around and talked to me about it, rock, I was paper, like, scissors. Hey, fuck you, man. You want to go out and duel?
Our duel would be rock, paper, scissors.
That's your duel. That's rock, paper, duel. Scissors.
That's my go-to.
That is the least violent, most accepted one you could probably do.
It would be my go-to because it's very, like, psychological. Like, you can play mind games. Plus, this is actually something that I do a lot. I haven't done it with you because we haven't been in that scenario. But for example, like when I used to work at a restaurant, I remember this one scenario perfectly. There's this girl. She goes, hey, can you cover my shift? And I go, I wouldn't mind to cover your shift, but I also don't really want to. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to rock, paper, scissors one time. And if you beat me, I'll cover your shift. And if I beat you, then I don't.
Okay.
And I won. And she was really upset. And I was like, it's one game.
Right.
It's all luck.
Yeah. It's all luck. Really luck. Exactly. It's not really. It's chance, though, you know, because you're trying to think like, OK, this person thinks I'm going to do this, but you have no idea what they're thinking. And there's only three options.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
So that's something that I actually do a lot. So that would be my go-to, a rock, paper, scissors game, but one game. It wouldn't be best of three. It'd be one.
Okay.
Win or lose, move on.
Yeah. One game. Mm-hmm. That's a good one because it's effective. You know, it gets the job done. You don't have to be physically fit. You can't. You don't have to be strong.
Yeah.
I guess you pretty much just don't have to be retarded. And then you can do it, you know?
You could also, like, carry a Switch around and be like, I challenge you to a duel. What are the terms? We got to play Smash. We got to play Mario Kart.
Yeah.
You have to beat me in one
race. Take it out of your pocket. You're like, here, come on.
Here's your control.
Let's go, motherfucker.
Let's go. And, like, if you don't play video games, you're like, I don't know how to play this game. And they're like, do you accept the duel or not? Because if you don't.
Do you accept it or not, man?
Because if you don't, you're a bitch.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
You're going to get shamed, motherfucker.
You're going to get shamed by everyone in here.
Yeah, non-dueler. Fucking bitch.
Now, what are some scenarios this can go wrong?
Okay, so I was thinking of this, too.
Were you really?
Yeah, so what if a guy comes in?
Yeah.
You accidentally bump him. He wants to.
Well, he gets offended.
Yeah, it's the other way around maybe. So the chances are that he wants the duel, but he wants to fist fight.
So his duel is a fighting match.
Yes, a fist fight. And it's not like like bloody to the death. No, it's like first one who's down and doesn't want to get back up loses. Mm-hmm. But it's a legit fist fight. You don't want any part of the physical altercation, but if you don't do it, you're going to get shamed.
So is it shameful to start a duel and immediately forfeit, right? I'm not a fighter. Unless if I feel emotionally invested, I'm not going to fight you. So I would avoid getting shamed. I'd be like, okay, let's go. And then the fight would start and I'd lay on the ground. I'd be like, okay, you win.
I feel like that's worse than...
And then I just walk away. I'd be like, okay, congrats.
But for your manhood, though, I feel like that's bad.
That's just an example.
Providing an example.
Right, laying on the ground is obviously like, you know, being submissive. I don't want to do that.
I would say you'd have to take one punch. That's what I would say.
Okay.
Take one
hit.
So
you start the fight, you take a punch, you go, okay, I'm not doing this.
Yeah, just...
And like, you win, bro.
Yeah. You're like, I really don't want to do this. So then you just go to square up. You're just like, just hit me. Punches you and you're like, all right, I'm good.
So
like,
I'm done. What about when people start a duel, but it's not... Right. Like, they don't do it. It's not a justified duel. Like, they're in the wrong.
But ah,
they
want to duel you. That's another good question. You know okay. what I mean? So there's stipulations to this.
There's a lot.
All right. So maybe whoever else could have witnessed it has to rule. Someone else has to judge on who was wrong in the situation.
I like that. I like that. You have to get an impartial third party.
Non-biased. Right.
So, all right. So here's a scenario. You're in Starbucks. I don't drink coffee, but you're in Starbucks and you're waiting for your drink. And you pay for it and they call your name. And you go up to grab it and some dude grabs your drink. And he starts walking away and sipping on it. He starts drinking it right away. And you're like, hey, bro, you grabbed my drink. And he was like, no, this is mine. And you're like, no, that has my name on it. He looks and goes, oh, so it does. And he just starts walking away. And you're like, what the fuck, dude? He goes, what the fuck did you just say to me? And I'm like, oh, I called you a bitch.
Yeah.
Like, let's say I called him
right,
a bitch.
Right.
He's like, all right, we're going to duel now. It's like, you're the one that fucked me, right? Like, you're the one that kind of started this.
Yeah.
So what happens there? He challenges me to a duel. You know what? I would just fuck him over. I would set the terms.
I was going to say, I think if you get to set the terms at that point, right? He's like, nah, let's duel. Then you're the one in position to set the terms. Mm. So I would do something. At that point, I would do something I know I'm better at him than.
I would be like, if you can guess every single add-on to that coffee, like hazelnut milk, and exactly how much, you win the duel.
Yeah.
If you can't, I win, and you have to buy me another coffee.
Yeah. That's a good one.
This shit solves itself.
That's a good resolution, dude. That's a good resolution,
bro. You know.
See, we gotta offer this to the government.
This is real shit.
This is real shit.
This is real. I think, like, how this world would be a better place.
Yes,
it'd be a funner
100%. We would have to get a global agreement, but I guarantee people would be accepted to that. They would accept that.
If everyone knew all the terms and everyone was properly informed, I think everyone would be like, "Hey, that's." Fair.
Yeah.
And is that not how the world was a 100 years ago?
Yeah. I mean, I think death was involved though.
It
was a little extreme, I think.
A little extreme. Yeah. It's like, I'll challenge you to a duel.
Yeah.
A duel of wits? No, I'm going to shoot you.
Yeah.
Kill him.
Or even like with a sword and a shield. Oh my God. Imagine like chopping someone's like hand off and he's like, I'm done. You're like, no, you're not. Like, just
doing it. Yes. I think about living in those kind of times. Like, I wouldn't be a combatant. I don't think so.
I think I would, but I feel like I'd die really quickly.
I'd be like I'd be some kind of scholar or a teacher or a philosopher, but I would not, or a writer, I would not be a combatant or a farmer. I'd be like a farmer or maybe like a, you know, a merchant, but.
Yeah. A merchant would actually be in my forte.
I would love that.
I really like doing like selling or like making my own shit and selling it. Like, I'd love to like make a armor or something and sell it.
Oh, you'd be like a
blacksmith.
That'd be dope.
Yeah.
It's funny. Like, when you think about blacksmith, you think fantasy world, but not really.
No, yeah.
Or like 100 years ago.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they're still around. It's just
not more, common, though.
It's just machine made, really. I mean, the person who is a blacksmith now just sharpens blades and shit. They don't really like.
They have all the knowledge. They might not use it, you know?
Right. Right. So I kind of want to stick on that, this old timey kind of theme, though.
Word.
What if back in the day, like, dragons were like 100% real?
Okay.
Like, it wasn't just mythology.
Okay.
It wasn't just us hoping for lizards that were used to be, you know.
Yeah, flying dinosaurs.
Yeah. No, it's like legitimate dragons that can shoot fire. They have extremely tough skin.
They're intelligent. More intelligent than a human being.
Right. They have to be.
The average human being.
Yeah. So I would think, like, I would try to befriend them. Okay. I would try to tame one. You know,
what's the scenario like? Do they not like us? Are they not a fan of humans? Do they have their own continent?
I guess like anything with animals, really, it's just animals go to war. You know, it's in our nature. So
you think humans, we'd fight the dragons?
I think humans would naturally go to war with dragons.
Yeah, it'd be an Aragon.
Probably over a disagreement of land, or a human wanted a dragon, the dragon didn't want it, and the human forced it type of
consent.
Thing.
Yeah, that's right up a human's alley.
No consent. That's what we do, that's humans.
Fucking savage.
No consent. That's fucked
up. Yeah, somebody stole a dragon egg from like big time dragon. Yeah, that'd be kind of fun. So you'd try to tame one?
I'd try to tame one.
You'd go to the dragon continent to befriend the dragons?
Yes. I would go to their land, their territory, with no weapons, no anything.
What if it's like the world today, though? Like, it's not a fantasy world. It's just like the world today. We have cell phones, we have cars, airplanes, but there's just like...
And dragons.
Alaska, like, nobody goes to... No, not like Antarctica, because there are dragons there, and it's their territory.
Yeah, okay.
So you would try to get there?
Yeah, I would. I think so. I'm very interested in shit like that. I feel like if there's a more superior species than humans, I would want to know more of it. I want to learn from it. I want everything I can, you know what I mean? Like, I want to be able to be friends with it type of thing. I don't know.
I agree. Yeah, absolutely. That'd be a lot of fun, right?
I feel like dragons would be badass.
That should be dope. And you'd be the only motherfucker with a dragon. You know what I mean?
Imagine if you like could ride it and shit. Like, what I got a private jet. I got a dragon, bitch.
What if they're outlawed and they can only reside in that continent? They are not allowed on the other continents. And if they're seen, they are immediately shot down.
Yeah, that'd be tough.
Would you go live with them, or would you like stay with them and come back?
I'd want to, but you know, it's Antarctica, you know, because so at that point, like,
there's no Wi-Fi.
That's not really where I was going, but it's cold,
no,
man.
No porn, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Zero porn.
No porn. Heck, I could just, you know, fuck a dragon.
Oh my God.
Ew. No, dick
would burn off.
I think that the coldness would push me away more than anything. I'm not good with that cold. I don't mind New England, but New England's probably as much as I can take. I'm not a huge fan
of the cold. You wouldn't go farther north than here?
I don't think so.
It's pretty fucked.
Yeah.
We get really fucked up winters, dude.
We do.
We get like 5 feet sometimes.
I don't know. Would you go to like Russia? Would you spend a winter in Russia?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't think I would.
I mean, I've been to Canada during the winter.
Yeah.
It is cold. Like, it's a different cold. It's a cold that reaches your bones.
Yes.
I wouldn't like it. I really don't like the cold. But I mean, yeah, fuck it. Why not?
Yeah, wouldn't really bother you.
Yeah, I would bother me, but I'd be like, fuck it.
Yeah, whatever. Deal with it.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
I don't know. There's something about
dragons.
Dragons.
Something about dragons.
I know. We spent the first 15. This episode is going to be called Duels and Dragons.
Oh, dude, it's going to sound like the nerdiest shit ever. I know. It's going to be fucking awesome.
Yeah.
You stupid fuck. Are you still wearing Old Navy? You dumb sack of shit. Go to alternativeoriginal.com. What the fuck are you doing?
Hey. Okay. That was it.
I'm wearing fucking.
Is that what you're wearing?
Alternative original, baby. This thing, I feel like I'm in a blanket right now. Like, I feel fucking.
Alternative original, motherfuckers.
Yes. Probably the most comfy winter jacket I've ever worn. Looks comfy. This thing is wild. Got a diesel ass hood.
Straight from a koala bear.
Mm-hmm. And you can like tighten the thing so it's like a.
Tighter than a.
Tighter than. Probably gonna have to cut that out. but yeah, it's an ill snowboarding jacket, real ass material. I'm actually starting to sweat just sitting here. I also got the fucking sweats on. But you can't see that in this. But
the
they're all so.
Sweats, kid.
Yeah, so fucking
cool. Look how fly this fucking guy is. Are you kidding me? Are you waking up in the morning, you're putting on your fucking Baby Gap clothes, and you're telling yourself you're not going to shop at Alternative Original? Look at this fucking guy.
Look
all
at
right?
me.
He's fly as fuck. He's dapper. You want to be
this
that fly?
This is beautiful.
AlternativeOriginal.com, TBV Podcast. That's the promo code.
Again, discount code TBV Podcast. You will get 20% off your entire order. It's urban streetwear. They also sell art, other urban accessories as well, and it's all custom made. Alternative original clothing. Back to the episode.
It'd be a lot of fun.
Do you believe in clairvoyance or psychics? Psychic abilities? You ever experienced anything like
it? You know, I did for a little while.
You did.
And to an extent, I do. I think that certain people have this. All right. Listen, man, I'm going to, for somebody that doesn't believe in the supernatural, I'm going to get a little controversial on this, okay? I feel like there are three parts to a human. I feel like there's the mind, the body, and the spirit, or the soul, whatever you want to call it. And I feel like that third part is the one that we really don't tap into at all.
Yeah.
Especially now in this day and age.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I think the spirit is what helps people, you know, commit miracles. Like when they're like when someone has cancer and they're at death's door and they're gonna die and everyone's like, oh, this person's not gonna make it, and they make a full recovery.
Yeah.
Like I feel like that's the spirit. I feel like that's your will. That's who you are on the inside fighting against equilibrium, which is death.
Yeah. I mean, I kind of agree with you, to be honest. I feel like that third piece is whatever connects us to the universe.
Yeah. It's the link to life.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's something that we can traverse. I don't think it's something that we can mindfully control.
I kind of, that's where I think I disagree with you. Mm. I think we can tap into it a little bit.
But if we could, we would have at this point. There would be documentation. And I arguably people have tapped into it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, I guess, when I say tap into it, I don't really mean like if we study hard enough, we can start telling the future. I more mean along the lines of like, I don't know, even controlling your emotions in extremely tense situations is you tapping into the universe a little deeper. Because you at that point are like, I don't know how to explain it. Monks, I guess, is the best
way
to explain it.
You're finding peace.
Yeah, you find peace.
You find peace.
With shit that you know you shouldn't be in peace with.
You shouldn't be peaceful with, right? Yeah.
So, I don't know. I think there's stories, dude, of people that... I guess I don't really believe that either, though.
Right.
They guess how they're going to die down to the bullets of... Where they got hit, how many bullets hit them, and it happened. And there's war stories of it, but it's stories.
Right.
Which sucks.
So, you know what's funny about that is that's one side of the coin, but I think the other side of the coin is like when people will stuff into existence and they will the universe for things to line up in the universe for them.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't only mean successful people, but I am going to use them as an example. Like people that, you know, grinded it out and really believed from the beginning that they were going to make it somewhere and told everybody and willed that into the universe. And lo and behold, now we have Logic. Now we have Kanye. Now we have Jay-Z. That's just an example, right? And just using rappers.
That's actually a great point though.
Right.
That is a good point.
I think that's part of the spirit. But
the music, I think, is a big piece of that.
Music is of the vibration of one's energy, of one's soul, of one's mindset. And I think it's really underrated.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people don't tap into that.
The fact that humans were able to create music out of nothing. We took wood, metal, silver, turned it into instruments.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's wild.
It's something music is found in nature. You know, there is music in nature.
Yeah.
Birds are a great example. I mean, why do they create melodies and what are melodies? I think there's something behind that. So, I mean, the real reason I believe in this stuff, and this is coming from a skeptic, I don't believe in any supernatural stuff, is... All right. Actually, before I go down this, let me ask you a question. How much of this do you think is tied to hereditary? Like, how much of it do you think is tied to your genes and your background?
Okay.
If any.
That is... one of the points I was going to make on this.
Great.
There is a fortune teller in New York that is still alive to this day. Mm-hmm. I don't remember her name off the top of my head, but her whole family has been for generations fortune tellers, more or less. Mm-hmm. And now it's just they're more called psychics. Mm-hmm. And she apparently gets everything correct. And I don't know. She says it passes down from all her – the women in her family all share that gene.
Right.
I do think some people might have the ability to maybe sense something like that before it comes, even with other people or in their own life. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think a part of it comes through their genes.
I think sense is a really great word to use because like when you use words like clairvoyance and psychic, people are like, but sense is fucking, I think that's spot on. I think it's very similar to like your sense of smell, your sense of hearing, your sense of sight. It's a sense of feeling. It's a sense of being sensitive to the vibrations around you. And I mean, is there something to that? Maybe. And the reason I asked you this hereditary question is I actually have a weird family myself. On my father's side, for generations, they've been like voodoo people, like shaman people, like the shrunken heads.
Yep.
That's just my hereditary. That's just it is on my father's side.
Yeah.
On my mother's side, it's very, very evangelical and Christian. They've always happened. I don't think that ties into it, but it's just a part of it.
Yeah.
So my father, as a kid, not even as a kid, but like as a young adult, he would tell me like, oh, sometimes I have little, you know, premonitions, little visions, and they come to fruition. And I didn't recognize at the time, but I have little moments too, and they're dreams especially. So like I'll have dreams of a scenario and then it'll just be like a blip. It'll be like looking in my own eyes 3 years in the future, but just for a split second. And it'll be like, oh, I'm sitting in this car with these people and this night, it's this temperature that we're talking about this subject. And then I won't really think about it or remember it. And then 3 years later, I'll be sitting in that car in that exact same scenario. I'll be like, oh, I already saw this happen once.
Dude, That exact same thing has happened to me.
That happens to me all the time.
And that's where I think deja vu comes from.
Mm-hmm.
I think deja vu is a glimpse of us looking into the future or a past future that we just saw in the past, but we know it was coming type of thing.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm kind of with you on that. I do feel like people can do that. I feel like almost anyone can do that. That is really interesting though. That do you think that happens to you often?
A good amount.
Yeah.
I've seen.
So you do kind of, I don't want to say believe in clairvoyance, but you think people get that sense of.
I think there's a lot less that's up to chance than people think.
Right.
You know, I think a lot of it is really like you're on a path and you're going to follow it. But I specific scenarios for me are like the jobs that I've gotten. Like I've had dreams of a specific building, of sitting at a certain desk, doing a certain thing. And then a year or two later, I'll be at that job doing that thing.
Okay.
So I'm like, for me, that's hard enough evidence to believe that there's something. I don't know if it's relevant. I don't know if it matters. It probably doesn't, but.
Well, no, it could though. You know, I don't know.
I mean, the reality is, how much does it matter? We're only going to live a maximum of 100 years, if anything, right? And it doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things.
Well, a big piece of that, and I do have a dumb question at the end of this that we can branch off to, but a big piece of that, I think, is that when you. So I guess, I don't know, you have like an act for sales type of thing. I feel like when your brain knows that, so at one point you kind of knew in the future you were going to be into that field.
Mm-hmm.
And then your body tapped into it, your spirit tapped into it, you saw a glimpse of what that could be, and you made it into fruition. So I do think—
Absolutely, could be.
You know, I do think that when people are like, I don't know, I have a huge like creative passion. I feel like I've seen shit, I've dreamt shit. I don't know. We're going to get serious. We're going to get deep, but I like these interesting conversations.
I do too. I don't know how much other people like them though.
Yeah, we can get dumb.
Debatable.
So I do like it when I listen to podcasts, but again.
Me too.
Say you have the ability to see other people's futures. You cannot see your own.
Okay.
Do you tell people or not?
Yes.
Okay.
But I'm going to pick and choose. I would use my indiscretion, and it would be my life mission to use that to people's benefit. Like it would be a defining characteristic of me. I wouldn't like be a stockbroker and have that power.
Yes,
like,
exactly.
A characteristic of you know, my future.
You want to use it effectively.
Right.
You want to change people's lives for the better. So say like some guy comes up to you, right? Random dude. You're at fucking you're at T-Bones one night with a girl.
Mm-hmm.
Some guy passes by you and like brushes up against you, and you just get a glimpse of his future. He's gonna die in 3 days.
Yeah.
Do you tell him?
I can't save everybody. Probably not.
Yeah.
If it's something.
I like that answer.
Yeah. Right. So like if it's, I think that's not specifically probably not. If it's like, oh, you're going to fall off a bridge in 3 days by accident, I'd be like, hey man.
Ooh. Still though, I don't know if I would tell even a random person that.
I'd be like, hey man, watch out for heights. Like just something really.
Give them a little.
A little nudge. Like, hey man, you just. Be careful, because there are some heights that are really dangerous.
What if that pushes him? What if he's on that edge one day and he's like, fuck that guy.
Right. Like, and then I brush up against him and his death moves up a day, because he's like, fuck that guy. I'll fucking jump off this shit right now.
Yeah.
All right. So what about this scenario? Like I'm at a stoplight and somebody walks by me and I can see in 30 seconds, he's going to walk onto the street and get hit by a bus. In that scenario, I wouldn't say anything to the guy.
Really?
I'd be quiet. I let the timer. I count down 30.
What?
And like when we get to the last 5 seconds, I just grab him and pull him back.
Oh, okay.
And then he'd be like, "What the fuck?" And then it would, zoom.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't say anything. I'd just be like,
"Don't say a word."
I'd just be like, "Oh, I got you, bro. Don't trip."
I don't know if I even would, dude. I feel like you're kind of playing God at that point. Is where I'm getting at.
If you can impact, if you can save people's lives around you, then I'd do it.
Well. What if you saving this guy? What if the guy you saved just happened to be a rapist and a pedophile?
That
you know
is
what
the
I mean?
Consequence of this ability that that right there would be a defining like moral. Like if this were a book, it'd be the main character's like one of his biggest.
This would be a good fucking book. A good
it'd be
movie,
a great
dude.
Book.
This would be a good movie.
I'm pretty sure there's already. This is definitely something, but for sure, this would
you
be
think?
A defining moment in the character's. You know.
The arc in his
character arc, right? It'd be like, oh fuck, but this guy that I saved raped And that's a horrible, awful, right. awful
But we want to give a bad example. You know?
I wanted to have weight. Like,
exactly.
He raped this girl that I went to school with and I was friends with. So, right. like, you got to accept that.
Yeah.
I think that'd be cool, but it's just part of the process. You'd have to accept your consequences.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, on a daily basis, I accept the consequences of my own actions anyways.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So.
Do you think there's anyone like that today? That is like kind of playing, they can literally see the future and they're trying to save people, but they just can't get it right. No,
I don't think so. I, you know, man,
I think someone is, to be honest. And I know it sounds weird, but I think there's at least one person out of the 7-8 billion people on the planet that can tell the future.
So
like vividly, I think there was one single person, at least one.
Like humanity has a chosen one. And like when he dies, another one will get picked.
Maybe. Yeah. Maybe.
That'd be really cool.
Right? Every 1,000 years, there's one single human being that is born with the ability to completely see the future.
And like that person will decide either, you know, will the human race continue for another 1,000 years?
Yeah, right.
Will they go to ruin? And that person is Donald Trump and we're going to be fucked.
Right? Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Like I'm telling you, China. It's going to do it.
It's going to do it. And...
We didn't listen.
Now we're all dead.
Right?
We're all dead. It's like, it's not even his fault.
That'd be so fucked if it just happens to be like fucking Kim Jong-un or something.
Right?
It's just like a wicked fucked up
and
guy.
And he just decided like, I am not going to let the human race continue.
Right? Yeah. He's like, I'm going to blow this shit up way before that happens.
Well, you know what? It would be like setting, because it'd be a normal human, right? So you'd only live a maximum of like 100 years.
Yeah.
So it'd be like setting a course in motion, so that way in the next 1,000 years we wouldn't be around.
Yeah,
that'd be really cool. That's a really fun concept to play around with.
Right? Yeah, why not? I don't know. All right, so let's say
this is like the fictional episode.
Yeah, I was gonna say I like doing these all like, cause cool. We don't know, we don't have topics, let's just bullshit the whole time. Mm-hmm, you know. Mm-hmm. All right, let's say animals can talk. What animal and why? Only one species of animals can speak. What animal and why? I mean, everyone's going to say their go-to is going to be dogs, but I feel like, I don't know. We got to get creative.
Right.
I'm going birds. Sorry.
I'm going to go.
I couldn't wait.
I'm going to go roly-polies.
Roly-polies?
Yeah. And all they say is rolling. And they're loud.
Oh,
so like,
man.
They're like this little tiny fucking thing and they're. Fucking tiny, dude. And loud as shit.
Do you want to describe roly-polies for people who may not know?
Oh, imagine like an armadillo, but it's an insect. So
they're pretty big though, insects.
I mean,
right?
Aren't they really.
Like this big?
No.
What?
No,
really?
Not even close.
I don't think I've seen one in person. So.
Really?
No.
No, they're pretty small. They're like half the size of a fingernail.
Okay. They are pretty small. So they're a legit insect.
They're a legit insect.
And they you can like, hear them?
Yeah. Like, I want to be super fucking loud, bro.
Okay.
And they roll up like an armadillo into a ball. And they're called roly-polies because when they're in danger, they just roll up and roll around. And
right.
Wherever
yeah.
they go, they go.
Right.
So I want them to have voices. They're going to be really loud. And they'll go roll. And you'll be sleeping. And all you hear is multiple
from out rolling. It just gets louder and louder.
So like, there's going to be a big service to exterminate them. Like, if you don't like them.
As soon as you hear the roll, you just call the number. You're there's like a specific number for it to
24/7,
like,
middle of the night, they'll come out.
Like a 1-800
profession.
Yeah. Right.
There are a lot of companies that do it.
Okay. Because
they're loud. I want them to be like, like airplane taking off.
What?
Loud.
Dude,
like,
they're insects.
Yeah, I want them to be like, they speak and your mattress shakes.
Okay.
You're like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
If you have an infestation of them, like, you're fucked, dude.
That'd be fucking wild. So, do they travel in like thousands? Or is it just the tiniest one is that loud?
Yeah, the tiniest one is that loud.
Jesus Christ.
And they're not always yelling. So, like, you can have roly-polies and they can be quiet for like 3 years straight.
Okay.
Like, you'll never know it.
Then you start hearing the.
One night out of the blue,
roly-roly.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
New Hampshire would be deserted. Because they're fucking everywhere.
They're everywhere, huh? See, I don't think I've noticed one in New Hampshire, but I bet I've seen them before and just haven't really
known.
They're like
little. They look like little gray, like roaches almost, and they have a shell. And they're
are they kind of like beetle looking?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I do know what those.
And their shell has like layers to it, and literally like an armadillo. And they'll
I think I've seen those here.
Yeah.
I think I've seen those in this apartment.
Yeah. They're like little gray things. Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
Yeah.
and they're just really loud.
Yeah. You know? Jesus, that'd be bad. New Hampshire would be fucking
it'd be
deserted.
No one live here, dude.
Yeah, dude. Since the roly-polies took over New England, dude, I don't know.
Fucking roly-polies.
No one's been there.
And I don't know if they dig underground, but imagine if like there's a community under Boston and they're like so deep like you can't reach them.
What, like in subway stations?
Yeah,
in
subway stations. So you get in the subway.
Like in New York and shit?
Like you have to New wear York. Earplugs because it's just so fucking loud that if you take them out, you'll go deaf.
Damn.
There's so many.
I bet, because like in the subway too, it'd just be like surround sound. So it's like the whole subway just shakes every time they're because the whole thing is just shaking.
Yeah.
Wow, that could get wild. I like that one. I am sticking with birds, I think. I like birds.
You'd have talking birds. Would they talk though?
They would, and they would be annoying as fuck.
Yeah.
Like extremely annoying.
Oh, they would air your dirty laundry.
Yeah.
Susan's cheating on Jimmy.
Hey! I can see you in there. Hey! Hey, when they're just sitting outside in a bush, just screaming, hella obnoxious. I would, all birds.
Dude,
just,
that'd be sick.
That'd be annoying as fuck.
You're taking a shower and you have like the blind, like it's closed, but it's a lit like an inch.
Yeah, right.
And the birds go up and like, you have a tiny pecker.
Tiny, tiny penis, pecker. Tiny penis, tiny penis. Hey, tiny, hey, penis. Tiny dick, tiny dick.
And they're like, unit 7A, tiny penis, 3 inches. And you're like, what the fuck, what the fuck? And it's like, he's lying. He's not even telling the truth.
Yeah, right.
Like you're hung. You're like, you fucking look.
You motherfucker, this is big for you.
It's big. And he's like, tiny pecker, tiny pecker.
I do like the rolling out dirty laundry, like airing out dirty laundry thing. Now your bird lands on the side of the bush. Hey, hey, she's cheating on you. She's cheating on you. Hey, another guy was there the other day. Hey, just mad loud, mad obnoxious.
Tyrone was at your house last night. Tyrone was at your house last night.
People would be like, yo, what the fuck, dude? The birds don't lie.
Dude,
like,
there'd be pet birds in every house.
Every single
like,
house.
It would be a thing to keep a bird because like I gotta be a part of the drama.
You just put it in my head. Dude, birds would probably be used as like security systems. Yeah. They'd probably be used as cameras.
There would be birds.
There'd probably be birds in court cases. You know what I mean?
How cute would that? Like a little bird with a suit on and shit. That'd be so
little tux for the bird.
Little fucking tux.
I like this tux.
They have a little perch in the corners of every room and they just watch. And they just
birds
watch.
Just sitting in court. Bill Cosby did it. Like I was there. It happened.
They call out little shit, right? They'd be like intelligent, be like, you have sandals, no socks on.
Yep.
You have sandals, no socks on.
They're like, yes, this picture shows no socks. The bird's right.
Like, the rule is if you don't have socks, you cannot enter.
Right.
They kick you out right away.
That's a good one
too. You know what I mean?
God, look at us. What would be another funny animal? Dogs would be classic.
Dogs would be great.
You know,
I mean, they're, you can't go wrong.
They'd probably be annoying.
They'd be like a little brother. They'd be so fucking annoying. Like,
right.
Can we play? Can we play?
Or like a kid. Yeah.
Can we play? Can we play? And you're like, bro, chill the fuck out.
Like, shut up, man.
I don't know, man.
I mean, those were two really good ones. Roly-polies and birds.
I like the bird, though. I think that would be a really interesting world.
Would be interesting,
I'm trying to think of a funny one, though. I don't know. Like fish?
Fish would be crazy.
But like it would be that.
Like all fish?
No, it'd be a certain kind of fish.
All right.
It'd be like a branch of fish in all the subsea species. Like
what about dolphins? Because like they're already smart as fuck.
Dolphins,
you know?
Yeah, we can do dolphins.
Yeah.
But like the thing is, well, I guess they breathe oxygen, so that doesn't matter. Huh.
Yeah, because would you be able to hear them if they were underwater?
That was my thing. Like fish could speak, but you can't hear underwater, and they can't speak above water, so it literally doesn't matter. So that would be like a really good one.
Yeah, I guess when you say it like that.
You got the talking trout, but like you can't hear them because it's underwater. So
when they're above water, they can't speak.
They only last like 10. They can only speak for like 2 seconds.
Okay.
And then they run out of breath.
Just poke its head up out of like the aquarium, like I'm in prison here. This is a jail cell.
They come up one word at a time. I need more shrimp. Like they're like asking for shit, you know?
Right, right. Yeah.
That'd be really annoying.
That would be really annoying.
Aquariums would not be as popular, or they would be really popular. I'm not sure.
I don't know. Like, dude, I think aquariums. Sorry, what were you saying?
I know. I was just going to say shit.
Okay. I was going to go on a serious piece. I don't know why I even
aquariums are fucked.
Yeah, I think aquariums are going to be gone in 50 years.
I hope so. They're not okay.
Dude, from what I know, the one in Boston, the big one in Boston is, they're like, they've heavily been running out of money before the pandemic because,
really?
Yeah, it's just, you know, everyone's starting to realize it. They're like, okay.
Well, here's the thing is small fish and small ecosystems, you know, that fish that aren't intelligent, I'm cool with that.
Really?
Yes. Like, I'm cool.
Oh, I get what you're saying.
Like, have you been to the one in Boston? You've been there, right?
I was really young. I don't remember it at all.
So it's actually one of the coolest ones I've been to. So you walk into the building and immediately there's 50 penguins underneath you. So you're on a platform and there are penguins underneath you and they just chill. I think that one's a little inhumane because there's not enough space.
Yeah.
But there is in the middle of the room, there's like a staircase that goes up and around. And in the middle is a giant tube aquarium.
Oh, I do remember
that. And
that
one is epic. Because they have a bunch of fish in it.
And it's big, right?
And it's big.
Yeah.
But like the biggest fish they have in it are like little, like tiny sharks, big turtles.
I
was going to
say, there's like stingrays in there, aren't they? I think I remember seeing
No, no, no. They have a stingray area separate.
Okay, maybe that's
that one is very inhumane. Yeah. I do not like that one at all.
That's the one I remember when I was a kid, I was like, why are they just like stuffed in there?
They have like 100 stingray in this one
tiny
pool.
It's like this tiny thing.
And all they do is go around and around.
Yeah, like that shit.
They do have a sub area where they go away and they have more space, but it's still not enough.
Yeah.
You know, plus they have scars on their noses because the arrows aren't big enough and they run into the walls and they hurt themselves.
Yeah. So, yeah. That's fucked up.
I think that's fucked up. I think the big tube in the middle with like all the various, it's like an ecosystem. They keep it up as a mini ecosystem and it makes sense. I like that.
Okay.
I don't like the whales. I don't like the dolphins. I don't like the big intelligent. I don't like cuttlefish when they have cuttlefish. Cuttlefish are one of the most intelligent creatures out there. Like, they're so fucking smart. They solve puzzles.
Remind me what the cuttlefish is again.
It's like a tiny octopus. So they have like this big head. It's like a sack. And they have like these wavy dorsal fins.
Okay.
And then they have tentacles in the front.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
And they change color to their environment.
Okay. Yes.
So they're really fucking cool, dude. They're my favorite creature. And if you go to the aquarium and they recognize you, they look at you, they walk up and they touch the glass. And they know who you are. So
what the fuck?
Bro, it's so fucking
dope. Can I get one of those for like my apartment? Do they sell those?
No, I don't think you can get one legally. But
really?
I'm sure you can
they're
get
exotic
one.
Or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, they're exotic.
Okay, yeah.
But cuttlefish
you
are...
You can't get one legally.
No, but you can get one. But dude, they're one of my favorite creatures. I can watch any documentary on them because they're just fucking so dope.
Yeah.
And if you go to the Boston Aquarium, they have this tiny tank full of like 6 of them. And it makes me sad because they're... like, dude, you can go up and you play with them. They fucking play with you.
I do think I've seen like videos of like people doing that shit where they like will go up and they'll do like mimic kind of what you're doing to them type of thing.
If you wave, they'll do this.
Yeah.
They fucking wave their
little
tentacle.
Insane.
And you're just like, this thing has so much. He thinks like you have tiny little tentacle hands. So like you do this and like they follow you and shit. And then they get bored. They go, okay. And they just walk away.
Yeah, they're like, all right, I'm done with this
human. I'm done with this human. And like, so I remember when I went to, me and my ex, we would go to the aquarium, blast it out of our minds, and just sit in front of the cuttlefish for an hour. And I'm not exaggerating. Like, I mean, edible high, like blasted.
Okay, yeah.
And we'd huddle up and I would hold her and we'd just sit there and watch and play with them for an hour.
That actually sounds like a good time.
It was so much fun. And it's like one of the best memories we have together. But like... it was a blast. So I don't like that kind of stuff because they sedate those animals to keep them there.
See, that shit too.
That's the issue is they sedate them.
So I guess I see two arguments for it. Aquariums being educational, I 100% agree with, but you don't need to physically see the fish to educate people on them.
Correct.
You can have all that really cool shit and just have big signs and billboards, make like models of them. You know
especially
what I mean?
It's 20, like you can have animatronic
You could
fish.
Have...
Like
you hit it on the nose, Ruben.
Dude.
You hit it on the nose.
We can make a little fake cuttlefish that does all the stuff that a cuttlefish does, and it'll last 50 years. You never got to feed it.
Yeah. And you could put it on a screen and animate it. You don't even need to put a real thing.
It doesn't need to be real.
And people will fucking love it still. It's not like, I don't know. So we solved that one really easily.
100%.
The second one for me was endangered fish. I think that is one good reason to have any type of fish in an aquarium. If the fish – so there's a lot of fishermen that are experts off of certain coasts and everything that in an area, they'll notice over the years there's less and less fish coming because they're getting eaten by the other fish there.
Right.
So they will capture them and try to relocate them.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hard to find other areas that suit them, so they keep them in aquariums.
Right.
That I think is okay, you know?
So, I mean, I guess the argument is, what is the purpose? Is it like the for the fish's well-being, or is it for the race of the fishes? Not the race. That's a weird word.
The species.
The species of that fish. Is it for the species' well-being? Because if it's for the species, then yes. Yeah. But the fish is still going to be uncomfortable.
It is.
You know what I mean?
It is.
They put chemicals in this water to make these fish more relaxed.
Yeah, you know that's true too. So I guess it isn't really a good way to go about it then.
Exactly. I think it's an argument that is just, it's never going to be perfect. And it's unfortunate because our world is being destroyed in front of us.
Yeah.
And in the next 50 years, I think we're going to see such a drastic change.
Yeah.
Like, this is not going to be the world that, like, we were raised in. And we were raised on animals and fish and aquariums. Like, I think things are going to change.
Yeah. 100%.
You know?
I agree with you. Yeah. I think this younger, progressive generation, they're going to get that shit out of here and all the power to them, you know? Fuck those aquariums. All they do it is for the money anyways. Absolutely. Fuck the zoos, you know?
The zoo. Oh, man. Fuck that shit. Elephants. Like, elephants are so intelligent.
I know we've talked about this before. Sorry, listeners, if we've repeated anything, but still, just fuck that shit, you know?
Yeah, straight up.
It's fucking stupid.
So, I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
Do you care about justice for the human race? Do you care about us lasting forever? Because I don't. I think it's a beautiful thing that we're not going to last forever. I think we're going to fuck up our environment the best that we can and then die off.
Exactly. I think, you know, everything comes to an end, and especially everything beautiful. All beauty comes to an end, you know?
Absolutely.
Everything beautiful must die. It's a quote by someone, but I think that the growth of the species across the board and humans, anything is important, but I don't think it's crucial. I don't think, like, I'm not going to die over it. Like, If someone was like, hey, if you do this, this, and this, you'll change the way the world is forever, but you have to work your entire life and you're going to clean the ocean, clean this, this, and this. I'm going to say no. I'm going to live my life out the best I can. And if the human race succeeds, then fuck it. You know, like, it's not for me.
That I would say that's a very unpopular opinion, but I think it's a very realistic one.
Yeah.
And it's one that people do on a daily basis and don't accept. Because you could tell that to a million people and be like, oh, that's fucked up. I'm like, okay, why aren't you cleaning the fucking oceans right now, dude?
Right. Why aren't you donating all your money?
Why aren't you go cleaning up shit on the side of the highway?
Exactly.
Go do that.
Yeah.
But they're not. So, I mean, it's a very valid argument. I personally, I don't give a fuck. I think it'd be really dope if, like, a couple thousand years, some kind of the next being came up as like, oh, look at all the evidence of these humans and what they did and their culture and their history. I think that'd be dope.
Yeah. You know? No, I agree.
So, I don't give a fuck.
You know, I don't know. Every couple thousand years, the Big Bang shit, that repeats. There's a new planet, ecosystem, universe, galaxy, reality. So, however old the human race is, we don't actually fucking know. We don't have documented science. But the planet's going to end, you know?
Yeah.
And then maybe it'll start again in a couple million years. Who knows?
Who knows?
Who fucking knows?
Who knows? And honestly, at that point, the scale is so grand, it's like, who cares?
Right.
It's unfathomable.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know. It's a weird concept.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. All right. We're going to take a very quick break. We'll be back after these sponsor messages. This episode is brought to you by Amazon Music. Amazon Music is one of the best exclusive music apps out right now. I actually use that because I have an Android, so I don't have Apple Music or anything. And the YouTube Music is kind of it's hit or miss sometimes. Not all the music's on there. Google Play is kind of hit or miss too. But Amazon Music has everything. You use the code BROOT and you can get 3 months free now instead of just one. So if you go to getamazonmusic.com/BROOT, B-R-O-O-T, you can get 3 months free of Amazon Music. Again, that's getamazonmusic.com/BROOT. Get 3 months free.
Now, with Hydrocell, staying hydrated doesn't have to break your bank. A 64-ounce bottle like this, under $30. Use our link in the description. Get yourself one today. Stay hydrated, you goddamn fool. Get yourself a 420 cleaner today. Under $20. Please, all your pieces, acrylic, glass, doesn't matter. Use our link in the description. You fool.
So it's Jake's knee?
Like this?
Like,
and then Haley's hand, right?
And then Haley's fingers.
Because I'm like, that's how you grab it.
You're like, dude, right when you said that, she's like, don't respond. I was like, I have to. And she's like, you can't. It's a part of the game. I'm like, fuck. So, yeah.
Dude. All right, whatever.
It's a pretty fun game, Do or Drink. It's a card game. It's wild. Some of the things they tell you to do are insane.
I feel bad, I gotta be honest with you, because I don't drink as hard as anybody around me.
Yeah.
I think I'm the leanest drinker out there.
Yeah, I was gonna say, we drank really casually yesterday for me and Jake. Like, there's still like 20 beers there. Like, we normally drink a lot more, you know what I mean?
Dude, yeah.
You're like, yes, I know.
I was just like, yep.
Yeah, sure, John. bingeables, you watch anything? You catch up on Dave or anything? Loki?
Nothing, bro.
I'll let you know right now, Loki's the best Marvel show by far now. The season finale came out. It changed the entire Marvel universe. That last episode probably should have been a movie.
Well, like, what about, dude, they announced What If? You heard about that one?
I have, but it's not like a legitimate movie series.
I know,
it's
but
like animated.
It's animated. It's not going to pertain to the story at all.
Yeah.
It's just going to be literally, if the TVA didn't exist, what would happen?
Right.
And Killmonger is in it.
Yes.
I fucking love that.
Yes.
I hope, bro, they need to bring Killmonger back.
He
needs to be back. They are?
Yeah. Well, they're making Black Panther 2.
Are they really?
It's been announced. So if it's in production, that means they found a character. And whether it's going to be what is his name? T'Challa?
T'Challa.
T'Challa's sister. Or if it's going to be Killmonger.
Oh, but you know his sister. I mean? Yeah.
It's going to be one or the other. Yeah. We just don't know yet. But I have a feeling it's going to be Killmonger. It is
I hope
sad.
So. Because he's an amazing character. And then he had that redemption at the very end.
Right.
He was like, no, I'll pay for my actions, you know?
Yeah, facts. So yeah,
like
that'll be dope. But yeah, Loki, it literally changed the Marvel universe. That I kind of want to give you a spoiler.
Good.
You're probably not going to watch like a lot of those shows. So
I am definitely going to watch it at some point.
At some point.
All right.
Do you care if I spoil it? I'll say that.
I spoil it for me.
You sure?
Yeah, a little bit. Ruin it, but tell me a little bit.
Well, if I tell you this, it's probably going to sum up most of the spoiler alert for people who haven't seen Loki or any of the Marvel shows. So the last episode broke
the sacred timeline, right? I read that on Reddit.
And Loki, the show is based off of variants of Lokis, mm-hmm. of different realities.
Mm-hmm.
So with that breaking the timeline, that made it so the Marvel Universe can now have infinite versions of each character. So a lot of people are saying Tony Stark and fucking Captain America are still alive, Iron Man and Captain America. I was like, okay, I don't want to go there yet because I get it, but those two characters aren't going to play them anymore.
Right.
There's rumors Tom Cruise might be a fucking Iron Man and an alternate reality.
That'd be hilarious, bro.
Also kind of confirmed that the three Spider-Man theory is correct.
What do you mean?
Because it said that there's multiple versions of every single person almost doing the exact same thing. All the big events happen basically across all the timelines.
Yeah.
So all these characters exist. So the Tom Holland Spider-Man, Tobey Maguire Spider-Man, mm-hmm. and Andrew Garfield Spider-Man, that's an actual theory now.
Through it.
Now that can really be done.
I hate that. I hope that doesn't happen.
Really? You're not a fan of it?
No. Tom Holland is the best. All right.
I do like Tom Holland the best now.
1,000,000%. He does justice. He is the Spider-Man incarnate. He's perfect. It was Tobey Maguire was the first guy, right?
He was the OG.
He was amazing.
Amazing.
I honestly couldn't think anyone could do it better than him than Tom Holland did.
Yes.
He did a much better job. But, Maguire did an amazing job. Who's that? That other guy was trash.
Andrew Garfield.
Trash. He's not even relevant. Fuck that guy.
I did like that movie they made with him in it, because it was the one where Emma Stone played his girlfriend.
Oh, God.
And the storyline of that movie was actually done really well.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't like him as Spider-Man.
Yeah,
I didn't really like the villain in that movie either.
It wasn't good.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it in like 6 years, 7 years.
Yeah.
So I don't really remember the plot. But I remember watching and be like, this is just not. He just didn't do it justice. It's like you were watching someone playing a part in a play.
Yeah.
You know, like an amateur.
You might want to move the mic a tiny bit closer.
So, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah. That just made it so it was wild because now there's so much different shit that can happen. The next Doctor Strange that's coming out is called Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness.
That's dope.
So it's going to be a multiple reality thing. They're going to go fucking wild.
I hope so. Marvel this universe. Is where Marvel needs to go. The last couple movies have been very concrete.
Yeah.
And the only way they can change that up and make and relive the hype, because how hype was Endgame when it dropped?
Yeah, dude.
Woo. Dude, the entire world was like, fuck Thanos.
Yeah.
I saw that movie twice in theaters.
Yeah.
Wow. I loved that
twice
movie.
In theaters.
I loved that movie.
Yeah.
That movie was fucking
I saw it
fire.
Once in theaters and then like four times off theaters.
Dude, that movie was so good. I cried at the end. I was like,
really?
Bro, yeah. I got a tear. When Tony Stark died, I was like,
I felt emotion, but
I was emotional.
I don't know if I got that far.
I teared up. Yeah. I teared up at anything though. I
do think that the acting was well done. That's I like those actors, you know, so obviously they did make it sad.
He did have a cheesy line.
He did.
I am Iron Man.
Yes. And it waited like 7 seconds to say it. I was like, okay, come on.
And that's
like, he's going like this. You're just waiting for it, but he waits like 6 seconds.
Yeah.
Then does it. You're like, Thanos could have just boom. You know what I mean?
I didn't like that, man. I wish he said something else. Yeah. Like, I feel like he could have been written better. What would you have
well,
done there?
So the point of that was that the first superhero announcement was Iron Man saying in 2009, I am Iron Man. So then a decade later, it's his last words as the superhero.
I mean, it's poetic.
That's all they tried
it just
to do.
It didn't do the moment justice.
It did not fit the moment.
Yeah, I feel like it didn't do his character arc justice either.
Yeah.
Like if he said something like, you know, this is for my friends and family. I don't know. Even something like dumb, like this is for my family. And this family.
I feel like he could have just got away with a fucking like Thanos just I win again, I'm inevitable, whatever he said when he flicked it and it didn't work. I feel like he could have just been like, not today, bitch. Something stupid would have even been better. You know what I mean?
I broke your thing.
Maybe not today, bitch, but thank you. I've been trying to get that off.
No, you haven't, dude.
I pulled it like six times.
No, you fucking did. If you wanted to pull this shit off, you'd
no, be I gone. Thought those were going to rip the couch, so I didn't pull it that hard.
Oh.
Yeah. But I apparently you got it off. I don't know how, but
hey, no, I just came off.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like something dumb could have been better. We can get off Avengers. We don't have to stay on.
I'll talk about this for an hour.
Yeah, no, same. Yeah. So you haven't watched Dave? Haven't watched anything?
Really? No, I've been watching a lot of YouTube videos, podcasts.
Yes.
Podcasts have been my big watch for the last couple months.
Yeah, same, you know? Same.
Because it's like, if you don't like the flavor, if you don't like what you're watching, just go to another episode.
Dude, there's so many different options too.
There's
you have
so many
a lot
options.
To choose from.
It's like, for whatever mood you're in.
Yeah.
And it's an easy way to kill an hour, man. Sometimes I'll be driving and instead of listening to music, I'll just play a podcast.
100%. I actually do that all the time. Cause I mean, I have a couple hundred songs. They get old, you know? Like,
do you listen to
this,
your own music?
My own music?
Yeah.
Occasionally, it gets old when you listen to it, rap it 500 times, then edit it 500 times, you know? It starts to get a little... Yeah. I do, when they first release, I like to keep it in the rotation a little bit, but I eventually just remove them. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you know, music gets old. I always throw on podcasts. It's fucking...
I feel you.
Yeah.
And no, not a lot of TV on this side, bro.
It's, yeah. I haven't watched a lot of American Dad, stupid shit. You know, haven't really been...
I love it, bro.
Yeah, haven't really been...
I love it.
...into shit. I did get Black Widow. I did watch that. That movie was, again, it was amazing.
Oh, was it really?
It was phenomenal.
You loved it? I've heard conflicting things. I've heard...
I mean, it was way too late. Like, if they release this right after
Infinity War. Is that when she died? Infinity
well, it, yeah, it took place in between Captain America Civil War and Infinity War.
Oh, really?
It
before
took place
she died.
In between those two movies.
Yeah.
But I think they were set to release it in early 2020 after Endgame. And like, we were like, oh fuck, like she's dead, but this is dope. She finally gets her own movie. But delaying it a full year, like the movie wasn't that good where you could delay it a full year. That's kind of what I'm getting
at. The timing was wrong.
Yes. Yeah. Way off. Like we already know what happened and I don't know. It was a great movie though.
Did they introduce any new characters that we're going to see?
They introduced a character, two new characters that you technically already saw if you've been watching the Marvel series. So,
all right.
Like the Marvel shows.
I feel like this can go one of two ways. I think this is all going to make sense and it's going to work out and it's going to be really chaotic and it's going to be really fucking convoluted for a couple years, but I think Marvel can piece it together. Or on another end of things, it can get really complicated and it's going to go nowhere.
Oh, like, I think they're already piecing it together really well.
I hope so. I really do. And I haven't watching, seen it, so I wouldn't know.
You gotta watch the shows, dude. What about WandaVision, like, Falcon and the Winter Soldier? They are going into everything very, very well.
What about the reason I say this is, number one, the sacred timeline is all weird. Number two, the new movie dropping about the Mythicals. What is it called? The Majestics? The Magic. Oh,
you know what? Sorry, the way you were saying it.
I don't know the name.
Fuck, now I can't think of it. The
Mystics, right?
No, but you're really onto it. You're really close. Yeah. It's like the Evelyns or something.
Something weird, right?
What the fuck is it?
I don't know. But they're supposed to be like a group of people that resurrect and they don't die and they live together in harmony.
Yeah, they've been living
thousands of years.
Thousands, if not millions of years.
And like, they're as powerful as the TVA. Like, I don't know how they're going to pull this all together. Like, I hope they do. But they did a great job with Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah. Did you know any of the comics about the what the fuck are they called? Deep. Jesus Christ.
I did the Avengers.
The Eternals. God damn it.
The Eternals.
I
didn't think
of it. I thought of the comic and then I thought of it.
You were saying like the Evangelicus.
I was like, what the fuck? The Christians. The fucking Christians. Yeah. So in the comic books, the Eternals, they've been watching and they know that it's being taken care of. So they don't have to do anything. Then when Thanos snaps, he actually wipes away some of them. So then they freaked out, but they're already dealing with shit when they're trying to fight Thanos. I think Thanos might have snapped away all of them. I don't know. Okay. They might explain it in the movie. I don't know. But in the comics, they were around the whole time. They just never interfered because they knew everyone was doing shit. So I'm guessing that movie's going to be good. The Eternals.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Oh, God. Another thing at the end of Loki, do they introduce Kang the Conqueror? Do you know who that is?
I don't remember who that is.
All right. Well, we can just talk about it after. We're going too deep into Marvel.
Yeah, I think we are too. People are like, freaking out. They're like, who fucking
I'll probably
cares?
Chop this up a little bit. We don't have to go.
Oh, my God. I feel bad. I could talk about Marvel for
hours, dude. That's the thing. We could do a whole episode on it.
Hell yeah, we could.
Oh, God. This is going to be funny. All right. I'm just going to tap into this first before I go into these other ones because we could go off on the other ones. Yeah. Bo Burnham's Netflix special. Have you watched it?
I have opinions about Bo Burnham, which impede me from enjoying his content. From the beginning, I was not a huge Bo Burnham fan. I never thought he was that funny. I never thought he was that. I thought he was creative and relatable, but I just never thought he was that funny, and I never saw value in his comedy. And to this day, I can't watch his stuff without going, I don't fucking care about this guy.
Jesus Christ.
And I'm so sorry. And
that was a deep fucking
I don't know. I don't know what I can do to change it, but it's such a weird opinion I have of
dude,
that
you
guy.
Went very wow.
It's the same.
You don't like him.
It's Bo Burnham. He's the guy with the puppets, right? With a he's a ventriloquist as well. He does like the
No. That's Jeff Dunham.
I hate that guy.
Jesus. So Jeff Dunham's who you're thinking of? The ventriloquist?
I just don't like them both. I think
Bo Burnham is the blonde dude that used to sing and
music.
Yeah, he's on Parks and Rec once. He
just doesn't do it for me, bro.
Okay, so you hate both of them. Jesus Christ.
I number one, I don't think Jeff Dunham is funny at all. Like, not even a little bit. Not even a little.
Yeah.
And Bo Burnham, he just doesn't rub my clit the right way. You
okay.
Know?
Yeah.
He doesn't get me off.
You know? Okay. I don't know if I should even bring it up then. Like that, his Netflix special is one.
I heard it's amazing.
One of the best.
It's a piece of art.
Pieces of art I've seen in a very long time, and I actually think you would love it.
I think I would too.
I don't think like so. He says stuff that like obviously it's supposed to come off as comedy, but. You when you're listening to it, you know it's serious. And that whole fucking special, dude, it's depressing. It's deep. Like
I heard that the same exact thing that you're telling me is that it's funny and it has funny moments, but it's gonna have you saying like, number one, I'm not okay, or number two, Bill Burnham's not okay. And
yeah.
That's the conclusion you're gonna come to.
It's yeah. I walked away from it wondering if I should reach out. Like it's deep. So I think you should watch it.
I want to watch it with a fresh set of eyes.
Okay.
Because I have a tendency to judge things.
Get high first, so maybe you won't be critical.
I get judged.
Oh, you get critical?
High.
Okay.
I get judged when I'm high. Yeah. I also get judged when I'm sober. It doesn't, it's fun.
That's a funny thing to get when you're high.
Yeah.
I get judgy. It's like, oh shit, okay.
I do. I am like.
I take shit less serious when I'm high, so.
I'm weird, man. If I don't like a thing or a person, or so I just won't watch it. I won't enjoy any of their content.
Yeah. Well, I'm like that with a lot of people. And I just never thought I didn't want to watch the special because I thought it was a comedy special.
Right.
And I was like, I don't care for Bo Burnham's comedy, but I like his musical creativeness. I think he's smart the way he does some things.
Yeah.
But boy, it was amazing, dude. It was a 9 out of 10. Like, it was fucking good.
I appreciate that. I'll definitely give it a watch at some point.
Yeah,
it was amazing. I'm bad at watching TV and movies.
Obviously. You are, obviously.
I am very
That's
bad.
That's a running theme.
That is a theme, and I've always been bad at it.
Yeah.
And the reason I'm bad at it is because I have a short attention span, and I get bored very quickly. I jump around.
Yeah.
So like, I can't watch a show for more than an episode or half an episode, and I get bored. I don't care anymore.
Yeah.
I don't binge watch TV like normal people. That's not something I do.
Does smoking emphasize that for you too?
A million like if you're percent.
Okay, so
I'll get high, and then it'll paradigm shift. I go, okay, now I don't want to watch something. I want to do something.
Okay.
So I'll go out and go somewhere. I'll cook something. I'll clean. I'll play video games.
Right.
You know, and then I'll get high and be like, I want to relax again. And then,
right. You know, it's never ending. Cycle.
It's a never-ending cycle. I've said it before, man, but at some point I'm gonna quit smoking weed and kind of see where that takes.
I was gonna say you smoke a lot too, right?
I smoke every day, multiple times a day.
Yeah,
that's which is aggressive
people,
and it's
honest.
Rough. And I think it helps for a lot of reasons, and then a lot of things it doesn't help. So
yeah,
you know. We said we were going to get silly and we did not.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I was thinking, I'm like, fuck, I do the same shit. I'm the same way. I should be
really?
Smoking soon. Yeah.
Dude.
You ever dealt with a fake orgasm?
I've faked an orgasm. We've talked about this before.
I have also faked an orgasm. Yeah. I thought we've talked about
We've agreed on this, that sometimes you're fucking and you get bored and you just don't want to fuck anymore.
Has a girl ever faked an orgasm with you fucking her?
Maybe. Who I don't know.
I think a girl has, and I called her out on it. I was like, why'd you just, I was like, we don't have to fake
it. You faked it, yeah. You could just say stop.
Yeah, I was like, well, if you were done, we're cool. Let's just finish up. Done, I'm good here. Like, yeah, I don't know.
I've been called out for faking it too.
Yeah.
My ex did call me out. She was like, are you not coming? And I was like, what? I think I evaded it and I didn't.
You're like, no, I did.
No, I came up.
I want to get food. Like,
yeah, like I'm hungry. You want to get food?
I got to go to the bathroom.
But like sex is great and it feels good. And coming is ultimately, you know, what you're looking to do. It's just like when you have sex, it's like the goal is to come.
Yep.
I want to come. And if you're not a selfish person, you want the other person to come as well.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean? But
most of the time. Yeah.
Most of the time. But sometimes you're just... I'm not gonna lie, I've had sex just for the sake of the other person wanting to have sex.
100%
And it's like,
dude.
I'm not,
and
I
that's
wasn't
what
even
I was gonna
it.
Say. Like, yeah. That's kind of my point to this.
Yeah.
Like, guys don't always just want to fuck. Sometimes the girls want to fuck, and the guys just do it for the girl. And then it's kind of like, why aren't you nutting? It's like, you wanted this. Like,
you wanted this.
Are we done here? Type of thing. Like, it's not
a question.
Mean.
My bad. Go.
No, I was just saying, it's not mean. You know, it's just us. You know. People can be done. And
it's not a question of whether you can or can't get hard, because as a man, I think that's a given. Like if she touches my shoulder, let's go. Right. But
okay.
What I'm trying to say is like, sometimes you're just like, sure. Like you're in the mood, like you're really horny. You're like, fine, I'll do this for you. And then she gets off and you're just like, I've been at this for 15 minutes.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Maybe you already nutted once. Or twice along that journey, and you're like at that, like you know when you nut and you're at that. This should have come way up earlier in the episode. We should have started with this. But like when you nut and you're not like once or twice already, and you're still fucking, and you're just like, this is doing nothing for me.
Yeah, it kind of the sensation kind of loses a little bit too.
If anything, it changes from a pleasurable to like it's rubbing. Like sometimes it's like it doesn't feel great. Like it's kind of
too sensitive. I think I get what
you're
saying.
Like, this isn't doing it for me. You know?
I think for me, it's more or less like that feeling when you nut the first time gets less. And then when you're, I don't know, it's just when you're fucking again, it's not like you don't feel like you're going to nut again.
Well,
it's
until
hard
it
to
comes,
put,
until it comes.
You think?
Yeah, I know what you mean. It is hard.
I've only nutted like I think three is the most in like actual sex sessions. Like, and it was over a course of like 2 hours, I'd say. So
Right.
I think three when was, I was the younger, most.
Yeah, I would like three. I'd say maybe four.
Yeah. That's funny. Me too. I was like 17 too. And this was when we were younger. We're only 25.
Exactly. Right. I'm like, years ago.
Fuck it, yeah. But still.
Anyways. But you know what? It's like, the more you nut, the next nut, the stakes are higher. And what I'm going to say is, like, it takes more for you to nut that second and especially that third time.
This is a conversation.
But that second and third nut is the best.
Yeah, because you got to go a little, like, you got to hit a little harder. You,
gotta,
you know what I
you
mean?
Gotta really, you got to like, really hit the right spot. You got to hold on. And you got to, like, keep that pace for, like, a minute. So, yeah. Like, you're sweating and I'm tired.
You're
I'm like,
fucking going.
I'm like, I'm there.
Right, you know what I mean? Like,
it's like
I feel like in the, it's kind of more enjoyable for them too. Yeah. Like I think they kind of get into it at that point too, because it's like, okay, at this point, like this is what we both need to get off.
Right.
It's, yeah.
I think that's said it perfectly. The stakes are higher, bro.
It's higher risk. Put it
higher risk, higher reward.
Facts.
Because like you can, I've been in that place where I've already come twice, and I'm looking for that third, like. Just collapsing nut, just like down and I'm out for an hour at least. Like I just don't move.
I don't remember the third one being like better though, but I do think I was like, so we were like actively drinking. So I feel like by the third nut, I was probably a little more drunk than I was on the first one.
Yeah.
Probably isn't. I don't know. I have you ever nutted drunk? Is it the same nut?
It's not the same nut.
I feel like it isn't.
It's a different nut.
Yeah.
It's a less sensitive nut. It's a more so. It's like a and like you go right back at it, you know what I mean? Like, and then like the moments pass, and you move on, you know what I mean?
That's a good point. Yeah, it's not as powerful, I guess.
It doesn't.
You don't go all the way to 10.
It's not as It's not as resounding. It's not a spirit changing.
On the flip side of that, nutting high, I think it goes like 11 out of 10. I think that's a little emphasized. I agree. I think it's a little.
Nutting high, it takes me longer to get there.
It does for me too.
Because like I'm more in the moment and I'm more conscious.
I think
shit.
I think a little more.
Yeah.
And I'm a little in my head.
Exactly.
Yeah,
dude.
I'm a little in my head.
100%, dude. It's just
That's mad funny.
But when you do nut high, it feels. When I'm high, I can only last one or two. I don't think I go much farther than that.
Dude, when I was younger, and this probably has probably an effect on my life's choices now, but when I was younger, I would take a mad NyQuil and ZQuil, and then I'd fight it off, and then nut.
What?
When I'm like, because you get wicked drowsy when you fight it off and you don't sleep.
Oh, I know that game.
You basically feel high, and then when you nut, it's tenfold better than weed, better than all that shit. Yeah, interesting.
Wasn't Tommy Lee doing that?
Yes,
he was doing that exact thing, right? He was taking sleeping pills and having sex.
Yeah, I wouldn't say sleeping pills. Well, I guess they were technically, but it was the sleep ZZZQuil. So it's like, it's not like an actual, like, I wasn't taking like Ambien and then doing it, because that'd be probably a little much. But
I think that's what he was doing.
Yeah, but I did try that when I was like 13. So I was pretty young when I tried that. Okay. So
all right.
I was like, whoa.
I'm trying now. Maybe too late.
It's pretty, I mean, dude, now, honestly, I probably will just pass out. Like,
yeah.
I feel like I'm getting old. That ZQuil, I'm just going to be like, I had a long day.
Dude,
like,
it's crazy to think, but I'm 25, bro.
We're feeling it. I'm feeling it.
I'm feeling it,
dude,
too.
Yeah.
I didn't feel it when I was 24, but I turned 25, and I feel like everything, like, my mindset kind of changed again.
I'm not going to lie. I think I agree with you, but I think a lot of it for me has to do with my change in my life, because I became manager and kind of started picking up more seriously on my music at the same time. So things started to fall into place for me and I cut back on drinking.
Right.
All three just kind of like it made everything a little better, you know? So this year I feel like I just feel like an actual adult, which is weird. I don't know. Not an actual. I don't know how to explain it.
I know.
I don't know how to explain it.
I know, bro. Trust me. I know. Yeah. That third nut. I know.
I wanted to bring this up. Dude, this fucking girl on Tinder, like,
yeah, you were talking about it.
So I'm kind of going at Tinder like more on a serious note now, because I'm seeing girls are doing that. And I don't know. So this girl I matched with, I was talking to her, and she's like up in Laconia, I think. Maybe not a little more north, I don't know.
Yeah, like an hour.
Yeah, which sucks, because I probably won't ever drive to like chill with her, but whatever. She was pretty cool to talk to, and she was saying like she checked out the podcast because I threw it in my Tinder bio.
Oh.
Smart move,
so
right?
So that's pretty dope.
I put co-host of the Brutal View podcast in there. So I'm thinking maybe they'll check it out type of thing. And I feel like it's working on some occasions. So this girl, she just randomly messaged me and she's just like, I know you're probably not going to read this, but it's really fucking refreshing to just see you having fun.
Yeah.
She's like, I know you guys don't get a lot of views and it probably doesn't feel like it's doing much, but just watching people my age just sit, talk, and have fun is really refreshing.
That's pretty dope.
She was like, it's nice not seeing you guys like on your phones. You're interested in each other's conversations. Yep. I was like, I needed this. Like, thank you.
That's really great.
It was really
that's
deep.
A great message.
It was deep. Yeah. I was like, thank you. Like, this was fucking great. So
that's amazing.
Shout out to you. I'm fucking
Hell
Tinder.
Yeah, that's awesome.
It was a great message.
What a fucking shout out to Tinder. Yeah. Shout out to you, girl. You're killing it. You killing
it. So just gonna be like,
keep up. She's like,
you're right.
Are you still talking to her?
No.
No.
Yeah.
That's how it goes.
Yeah.
She's probably not even listening to this one.
Probably not. Yeah. But it was fucking
it's all good.
It was something that I feel like we needed to hear it.
Yeah.
You know? And I wanted to tell Eric too, but yeah, I don't know if he'll be back.
It's a lot of fun what we're doing here. I really enjoy it. I say it to everyone that I talk to when they're like, oh, you do a podcast? And like, oh, you got any listeners? I go, nope. No, not at all.
Yeah.
And they're like, then why do you do it? I'm like, it's a lot of fun.
Right.
And my dad doesn't get it at all. He makes fun of it like crazy, but I'm just like, sorry, Dad. I just really enjoy it.
My parents didn't really understand it, but my mom got it after I said it to her. I was like, honestly, like... Mm. I don't know. Kids our age, we don't do this shit.
No.
And no one I know from around here, we barely even talk to each other. Everyone just stays in their own little circle and just works until they die. I want to have fun. I want to talk. I want to share stories. I want to fucking learn shit, you know? We can end on this. It was happy enough. You know, we're good. You got anything else?
What do I got?
I do have some shit, but I do want to head out in like 10 minutes. So.
Yeah, I know. Oh, that's right. Are you on a time?
Yeah, no, I'm going to head out at 12:30. I still got plenty of time. But we can, I mean, this is not a bad conversation. Do you think you're going to want a bachelor party if you ever get married?
Yeah, I'd like one. I'd like my friends to throw me a little bachelor party. And for me, a bachelor party would get, you know, really expensive food, really expensive venue. Expensive drinks, expensive weed. I want to get blasted.
Okay.
I definitely want a lap dance.
Okay, I was just going to say. Not a strip club type of thing or an actual nice place?
I want that to be a stop. Like,
okay. Yeah,
but to be honest, I've never even really been into that scene anyways.
Yeah.
I've been to strip clubs and they're whatever.
Yeah. Everyone knows my strip club story. I won't say it again, but.
Right. So.
Yeah. I'm kind of in the same boat. I feel like it'll be really nice. I guess the flip coin of this was, would you be upset with your girl having a bachelorette party? Probably at a strip club.
Here's the thing. It's like, if I'm going to marry this person in the first place, I have to trust them. And I have trust issues in the first place. So for me to marry that person, I have to trust them to a certain extent.
Really
so no.
Trust them.
I'd really trust them.
Yeah.
So no, I wouldn't be upset because I'd be like, listen, you can do what you want to do. And I trust that you're not going to betray my trust. Right. But to get to that point of marriage, I'd already be there individually or as a couple. So, I'd be fine with that.
Yeah.
Now, like, if it's a person I don't know, absolutely, like, no. And I only say that because I have trust issues, bro. Like, things that I'm dealing with and I'm aware of them. But as a person, you have to be aware of your flaws. And
yeah.
That's a weird conversation I have for the last 2 minutes. But.
Well, I mean... It was a really big conversation on a podcast and people were arguing about it. And I didn't know if we'd have funny answers, but I think you said it really realistically. And I agree with everything you said.
Yeah.
If I love that person enough and trust them enough to marry them, I don't give a fuck what they do. I trust them. You know,
I trust them. Exactly. Yeah, they're not going to betray me. And if they do, then that's not the person that I, you know,
not who you thought they were.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So like, I'm going to be honest with you. If I'm with another girl and like the last, whatever it is, what it is, but like if I'm with another person in the future and they cheat on me, like that relationship's over. And I feel like my trust is like compromised.
Right.
I'm going to break up with them. Not because of like in the past, I would have done it out of spite, like, to spite them, but it's for me. Like I got to do what's best for me, girl. And if you're going to do that, I'm all set.
100%.
I'm all set.
With you 100%.
You know? So.
And on that note,
we're going to end it there on a fucking weird ass.
Yeah, that was a great podcast, man.
I think so.
We talked. It was interesting ass shit. We made good points. We threw some stuff in there. We didn't fire jokes off the whole time, but who cares, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for listening.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in. If anyone listens this far, drop a comment.
Yes.
Send us a text. Do we still have the number
active? 603-922-4074.
Yeah. If you still listen, send us a text. It's not for advertising. We're just going to, you know, see if anyone does. And I think that'd be really cool if we got at least one or two.
Facts.
You know.
100% facts.
Yeah. Tell us how your day was. If something is going on in life.
Yeah. You can email too. broodofyou@gmail.com.
Yeah, right. That'd be really cool.
Again, tell your friends, share the pod, mm-hmm. subscribe to the channel if you're on YouTube. Absolutely. If you're on other platforms, we love you. Check out our sponsors and affiliates. We will be back next Wednesday. Happy Wednesday. Happy Wednesday, almost Friday. Y'all. Get through the week.
You're almost there, baby.
You're almost there.
Hopefully we get you next through the next two.
No one's going to listen this far, but I also have a song dropping Friday. What?
We should promote your music more on this podcast.
I say that, but I feel selfish. I don't like it.
No, so. Let's do it. John here is an artist. His name is Broot on all streaming services. He's dropping music constantly. Once a month. He already has a bunch of tracks up that have thousands of listens. So if you're looking for some kind of grungy, emotional rap, then that's what you want to listen to. I think that's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
I hope you don't take it the wrong way, but...
No, I don't care. I mean, the way other people interpret my music is exactly how I want them to put it, you know? I don't know. However they feel they listen to it is how I like it.
It's underground. It's underground real shit.
That's it, really. I always just categorize it. It's just underground rap. Right. And however you want to put any of the labels on it, have fun, you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, thanks again. We'll be back.